What's good, people? Welcome back to the video. Today we're reacting to some more Brockhampton. We're reacting to Junky or Saturation 2. I'm pretty sure Saturation 2 is probably my favorite album of theirs so far. If you guys have any tracks of any other projects that you think may sway me, then feel free. To be honest, I've had like everything suggested to me from different people. I've now had a few separate comments basically saying that for me to really understand the multiple bodies of work that Brockhampton have released, I need to do full album reviews. I would love to do full album reviews, but at the moment my upload speed is woeful, and it basically means that the amount of work I'd have to put in, and then I'd also want to release, you know, like single song reactions throughout, it would just be really difficult. I've actually managed to get in touch with our internet provider and hopefully gonna get it sorted out. It's just been awful for ages, but I've never really recognized it until I started doing this and I realized that uploading such a short video took so fucking long. But believe me, as soon as I'm capable of doing album reactions, I will, and you guys will be the first to suggest whatever you want. I'll probably just go through the series of albums from Brockhampton and some other stuff. I'm really looking forward to that. I do apologize for the single song reactions. I understand it might get a bit annoying just doing so many separate songs, but I just want to get a rough idea and I want to keep doing this for you guys, but I apologize for the inconvenience. Anyway guys, we're going to jump right into this. This has been recommended quite a few times, and at this point I'm just really excited to just jump into any Brockhampton track. So yeah, I'm just going to jump straight into it.
My heart out, looking out for my best interest. He gave me good head, peeping out while the window's tinted. I speak in tongues and I arrive without a damn.
I love it that he drops loads of gay references. I saw a video that got suggested to me on my like homepage of YouTube saying like straight guys reacting to Kevin Abstract's sort of like gay lines that he puts in songs, and it was just absolutely hilarious. And how awkward people get, it's just so funny.
I mentioned, it's kind of sick, and I was born in 1996, and 1999, the only year that I remember. I slipped through the cracks without having a damn temper. I bleached my hair because these bitches all about they bitching. I say shit when I'm rapping, y'all niggas barely listen. I do the most for the culture, nigga, by just existing.
That beat is disgusting. I really like that sort of beat, that little sound. I don't exactly know what it is, but it's sinister as fuck, but it's it gets me excited.
Delete my tweets cause I'm ashamed of being a fucking Simpson. I told my mama I was gay, why the fuck she ain't listen? I signed a pub deal in her opinion, fucking disappearing. I'm paying bills for my sister and trying to fund the business. Is it homophobic to only hook up with straight niggas? You know, like closet niggas, mask type. Why don't you take that mask off?
I'm scared what this is gonna drop into.
Oh, that's the thought I had last night. Why you always rap about being gay? Cause not enough niggas rapping be gay.
Where I come from, niggas get caught faggot and killed. So I'ma get hit from a nigga right here, and they could come cut my head off and my legs.
This is the bit that I saw that people reacted to and were like, what the fuck? It just doesn't fucking matter, to be honest, man. It does not matter.
And I'ma still be a boss on my head, got ya.
Trust nobody, cause they don't deserve it. Niggas running your house, they know you're doing dirty. I got my hand on an ounce and I got money serving. I just bought me a fifth and now I'm speeding swerving. I took an eighth of them shrooms and now I'm here.
I understand the reasoning behind why he's not in Brockhampton and stuff like that, but if none of that stuff happened, I feel like he brought such an awesome element to them. I feel like he brought an edge. It's this sort of like dark, proper hip-hop edge that I really appreciate, and I feel like, you know, they're still brilliant without him, but I do think he brought something really different, and I always enjoy hearing him on some of the older stuff.
Voices. I took like two of them pills, I can't remember nothing. I ain't under control, I'm losing motor function. I need an intervention, I need an exorcism. I need a therapist, paranoia and drug addiction. It's very scary, my mama don't even recognize me. I'm going crazy, don't need nobody to say they love me. My acts of desperation, I'm on an empty stomach. So fuck the consequences, I ain't running from them. Feeling like a gunner, put my life in like a hot box in the hummer, hot box in the summer. If I had a,
what is he lying?
I would do it all again. If I had an option, I would do it all again. I just wanna feel like I did the right program. I just wanna appeal to my dad and my cousin again. When I cut that deal, I do nothing but diplomas. Lovers knowing that you didn't do it by your lonesome. So I forgive my mommy, daddy, auntie, and my uncles for guilt tripping feelings whenever they
way it snaps on this. I'm enjoying this track. I don't know why. I feel like it's missing something, and I'm not sure why. I completely understand what you guys suggested it. I think the beat is really hard. I just think it's almost as bad, as weird as it sounds, I'm like waiting for it to sort of hit a bit more. Maybe that's just because the last track I listened to was just ridiculously mental. Then maybe that's why. But I'm still enjoying it.
Men dream, they see men falling. But when I dream, I'm smashing on a lana.
Oh, pessimistic, drug addicted, caught in our feelings. We spit venom, let's stare at the ceiling, wondering why.
My mom's no alcoholic, she just wanna drown her sorrows. Love her to death and soon enough I'll get back all I borrow.
I'm so submissive, take turns dominating. The light has been faded, the sexual love we don't fake it. No giving, just taking.
I took some steps to be a bigger person.
I love how Joba brings something completely different to every single tune. He's actually really impressed me the last few tunes I've listened to. I think you guys know, if you've watched multiple of the reactions, that I was just a huge Matt Champion fan. And then I feel like as time's gone on, and I really enjoyed Merlin's stuff as well. I enjoyed all their stuff, to be honest. I've said that exact sentence before. I've named half of them and then just gone, I don't enjoy all of them. But I do enjoy all of them. But Joba's really surprised me the last couple tracks, and I've appreciated him on a tune a bit more, and it brings it a bit more flavour, if you know what I mean.
Person, I should've thrown you off the highway, the car swerving. Ain't no burden, ain't no sermon, ain't no motherfucking plaque. I hate these hospitals and police and the smell of death, all that. I hate these shaded folk that want a lady like, but don't treat lady right. But they be saying like, and yeah, you mad cause she ain't fucked, mad cause she ain't sucked. Beat your ass before you got time to say why not. Hit a catch and slip up, wish you could just rewind. Time and not fuck up, thought you would just looked up. Where that respect, is your ass human? I look you in your eyes, say fuck you, are you fucking stupid? Respect my mother, respect my sisters, respect these women, boy. I get my 99, I don't owe one, hit the store to blow your brains off. Better hold my aim off, better hold the range off. Okay. Better put my tame up before I blow your brains off. No hands with the stunts, jump off the roof like I do what I want. All of my life and my past with no heart on my side of the future, beginning to top my ambition. Man on the moon, I'm a room, I ain't tripping, I'm on a mission. Every time that I speak, they ain't skipping. Turn my inspiration to a vision, that's a giving, no slip.
Okay, that was Brockhampton, Junky. I enjoyed that. Maybe not as much as some of the other stuff I've listened to, but I understand why you guys recommended it, and I did enjoy it. I really liked the beat, I thought it was hard. I just thought, in a way, like it stopped between artists and there was a bit of a pause almost, and it sort of made the momentum sort of go slightly for me personally. But by the end of it, I think after Matt Champion and then Dom at the end, I thought that it sort of brought the song together a bit more, for me anyway. Yeah, I enjoyed it. Maybe not as much as some of the other stuff, but that might be just because I came off the Iridescence tune, which was just ridiculous. But I still really enjoyed this, and I'm happy you guys recommended it. If you have any other recommendations, chuck them in the comments below. I'm literally doing a Brockhampton upload a day because there's just so many tracks to get through. Obviously, I don't want to do too many to the point where I can't do the album review, but I feel like there's so many that I'll be fine and I'll be able to go back to the album and sort of like vibe out for a second time to some of the tunes I've already listened to and get a better understanding of them, so it's going to be okay. Anyway, guys, if you like the video, drop a like, drop a sub if you enjoy this and you want to see more stuff like this. And yeah, guys, I'll see you in the next one.